Hello,
my name is Haruko Furukawa.
My name is Leona.
Меня зовут Саватеева Людмила.
It's going to be a really strong battle, and artists from all over the globe.
Let's go. Let's paint.
Okay, and right off the bat, we're seeing Belinda going hard, laying down some bright color right away.
All of these people are from different parts of the world. That's so awesome to see. Like, Art Battle is bringing everyone together. I don't know if you missed that, but Belinda was painting something, then turned her canvas upside down, and now she's painting something else.
It'll be cool to see what Lamonia's up to, because right now we just have kind of this blotch of this blue, and now she's bringing in white and bleeding out the edges, so I'm really not sure where this piece is going, and I love one that keeps me guessing. And I like Ludmila's kind of color blocking in here. I'm getting some Rothko vibes. Going right for some pattern work, using the tip of her sponge here. I am pretty familiar with Belinda's work, and it's almost always just really imbued with a sense of joy. She's taking quite a minimalist approach in these first few minutes, when we're seeing from a strategy standpoint that the other three artists are really trying to get a lot of ground coverage. She loves to encourage a sense of community and love and like inner peace. So I think that we're gonna see some symbols emerging from that. I am about this painting. I love this painting. I'm all about this gradient. I'm here for it. And I can see that she's working in a lighter color right now that I can't quite make out, that seems to be kind of lending itself into bleeding the other colors.
And you're right about Belinda's positivity. Look at all those hearts.
Yeah, all those hearts, and she's chipping into the negative space around them to make them stand out and kind of have this glowing quality. And now we've got a whale emerging into this color field from Ludmila. Oh, wait, could it be a fish? 7.5 minutes in, these artists have accomplished quite a lot so far. Just kind of seeing this like sumptuous blending of colors. Oh, and surprise there, where her canvas dislodged from her easel a little bit and created an unintentional pink mark that now she is involving in her composition. Voting is open, and you can vote in the Art Battle app. You can go to artbattle.com/app. All of these pieces will be also up for auction. So if you're falling in love with a piece as you're seeing it being created right now, please be sure to bid on these pieces and support these artists. Oh, wow. Curveball with Lamonia. Definitely a curveball. And now we see that she's layered color over top of that established, and you're getting some kind of grays coming through as she's mixing the color. And so I think that that's creating a higher sense of depth. Wow, these scales on, I think what we've settled on is a koi, is those scales are just looking fantastic. So I'm gonna take us on a little tour here, Belinda Fireman. And we saw her canvas go from a super warm cacophony of color to all of these hearts just cascading all over the canvas, color bursting, pattern elements being introduced. Haruko Furukawa, we were held in a guessing game with the initial stages of this painting as to what animal was going to be emerging. And we've discovered that it's this beautiful koi, creating this really beautiful organic lines, celebrating realism, as well as more organic elements of this painting. Lamonia Cocodilus at easel number 3. It looks like we have quite an abstract minimalist painting going on, and we've seen her work to really grow this painting in an organic way that celebrates the colors and blending colors on the canvas. Ludmila Salativa, we saw this piece emerge from this blue color gradient into an environment for a diver and a whale and we now are also starting to see lights being reflected off of the surface of the water, and is just creating such a wonderful sense of depth.
Lemonia's work is going from abstract to having some kind of form to it now.
The way that she's kind of chipped in on the side of the head as it goes underneath the base of the fish, that harsh line as it's contrasted with all of these, all of this rounder movement is really nice. The surface reflections that she's got going on is really giving me a strong sense of space and environment in this. Like, that's so whimsical. I want to be that diver.
I want to be that whale.
Belinda is putting on the final touches into her piece. I can see that she's surrounded her hearts with a light outline as well to kind of tie everything in. Just when we thought that she was starting to go figurative in this piece, she is going back to an abstract. She's obliterated that arrow. I like it, actually. She's tightening up this koi in such a wonderful way. You can tell that each brush stroke is just really, really considered. I feel like I could just live in Ludmila's.
Oh, yeah.
That'll be my happy place now.
Oh, wow. She's putting streaks of white to show, like, light coming from the surface. That's an eye of an artist right there. Every time I come to Art Battle, I'm like amazed and blown by all these amazing artists, like, and what they can do in 20 minutes. Like, 20 minutes isn't anything.
And you can take this art home with you. Art created in only 20 minutes. We like to say 20 minutes and 10 years. A lot of work, a lot of genius, a lot of talent baked up into these works.
Time is nearly done.
Four, three, two, one. Brushes down.